Hey everyone, today is a very exciting day for us developers. AWS has introduced its very own AI-assisted, AI-powered IDE called Kiro. And this is absolutely game-changing news for our industry. What we are witnessing right now is a very healthy competition in the AI-driven development space. We've got some fantastic tools like Cursor, which is now valued at $9 billion. WinServe, which was recently acquired by Google for $2.4 billion. We also are familiar with GitHub Copilot, which has been around for quite some time. And there's so many other tools that are currently available like Claude Code. We have Gemini Code. We have Amazon Q. We have tools from Vercel. And now we have Kiro. Now, what we are witnessing right now is not only we're getting some faster development tools, but we're also seeing a surge of how good these tools are becoming. These tools are not only catering to helping you develop code, but also it helps you across the board throughout the development lifecycle. So let's go through the announcement that Andy Jassy made on Xpost. So when introducing Kiro, he did mention a term. So I'd like to emphasize on this term that he used is the all-new Agentic IDE. So that's pointing out to the AI-driven IDE, but also some agentic capabilities. We'll talk about that when we actually go through the demo. But quickly, he talked about three key innovations. Number one, introducing the spec-driven development, where you start with a specification document. It will go through the documentation first before writing the code. And then you have the intelligent agent hooks. So that's something which I've seen in the videos where you can define hooks based on some events, like for example, saving files, as you can see here. Or if you make any commits, it will regenerate an event. And based on that, you can create some hooks. And those hooks can take some actions in the background. So those could be maybe writing test cases for you. Or unit tests, for example, or it can also create some diagrams or documentation and things like that. So we'll explore that in the upcoming demo. And then lastly, it's purpose built. So purpose built means it offers you. I've seen there's a demo below this where you have an option to choose between vibe coding or code with spec, right? And then if it's vibe coding, you can start with vibe coding to begin with. Just if you are starting with an idea, but when the code base expands, you need to specify, go with a spec-driven approach where you specify the documentation for your code base. So let's dive and start installing it. So let's see where the link of installation is. And we can go here. Yes, so we can go to the downloads over here. And in here, you have multiple options available. So you can choose between a Mac silicon, Intel silicon, which is for Mac, and Windows, Linux. And so for the sake of this demo, since I am working on a Mac, so that's why I'll select the download for Mac and Apple silicon. So I'll do that. I'll download it. And once the download completes, it would be available here. Okay, so the download is successful. Now we can just simply click on it. And we drag and drop to the application page. And I think it's successful now. And in the applications, I'll have Kiro. Okay, just run it, open. And now you can see there's a login option. So you have multiple options available. You can sign in with Google, with GitHub, with AWS Builder ID. And I think I'll go with this option for now. Let's see, with the Google option. All right, I can now close the window. Now I've logged in. Oh, this is an important step where you can import your settings, the extensions from Visual Studio Code. And I believe Kiro is a fork from the Visual Studio Code. So that's why you can see it's like that. I'll just close this window and I'll just import it. And now you can see the colors and everything, that the theme and everything is now getting imported. And in the meantime, I can click next. I can select additions. Right now I'm on solarized dark. Maybe I'll choose Kiro dark. I think that looks better. Sorry to blind you with the white theme, but yeah, let's start with the Kiro dark and let's see. And okay, this is good. I want to set up shell. What we'll do is that we'll now prompt with script for administrator privileges. Okay. All right, I need to. All right, so Kiro is now installed in the path. Now, all these extensions are getting installed. What I can do is either I can clone a repository, I can connect to something, but I'll start opening a project, for example, in under this. So we'll start with a simple project called Kiro test project. Okay, in this, we'll just start Kiro now. All right, so when initially starts, so there are two options available. One is the wipe coding option. The other one is the spec option. I recommend if you are creating your code base, I recommend you to start with the spec option because it will plan first and then build instead of wipe coding, which will just start with a chat and it will start building right away without creating the requirements document. So I'll do the wipe coding first for the sake of this demo and see how it performs. I'll just say I want to create a working 3D model of our solar system in JavaScript. Let's see. It's a very high, a basic ask, and it's a very high level ask, and it automatically now understood it needs to use 3.js, right, library. Automatically created our index file. It's creating other files as well. But one thing to remember, if we are going to go with the spec-based approach, it will have created the specifications over here. Agent hooks, we can create agent hooks, right? So any event that occurs, for example, any file changes, it will automatically trigger the follow-up action. And this is also, you don't need to write code for that. It's just a prompt as well. And this will be happening behind the scenes. So we can just say, and if the file changes, update the documentation, right? So we'll not look into this for the time being, but this is a very powerful feature, I would say. Then we can also have some additional documentation for the agent. We can define that. And also we have support for MCP, Model Context Protocol, to connect to external tools and data sources. So that's something which we can explore later on. So now it created some files, and we just simply need to open the index.html. That's cool. And if I go back to the path where I have hit install, let's open this. My God, this is cool. Okay, I can move around and maximize this. In just one prompt, it gave me this. And what about if I go back and I just say, can you add the name of the planet or the object now when I hover my mouse on it? So just want to see the name, what planet we are looking at, or the sun, the name of the entity or the object when I hover my mouse over it, right? So let's see. It is now, okay, so it automatically updated and I can see the difference, what it did, right? Okay, tooltip, that's cool. And now it's adding some mouse event handling as well, raycasting functionality. That's cool. We'll see that in a moment. And it did that as well to our main file. Okay. Cool. It automatically created everything for me. And now it's summarizing what it did. And now if I go back and maybe I refresh. All right. Yes, we can see it. If you follow it. Oh my God, this is cool. Saturn. This is Saturn. But doesn't have that. Can I zoom in? Oh yeah, I can. Cool. Cool. I think I'll cut this video short. Now that we have built our entire solar system with just one prompt, it is impressive. However, it's still in its early days, and right now it's in public preview, and we'd like to test it later on, maybe with some complex scenarios as well. I'm very much interested in the spec-driven approach, where I can create the specifications like the design documents and the requirement documents. I think that's just the next step which I'll be testing. And if you're interested in that as well, just leave a comment in the comment sections below so that I can focus on that and create a separate video for that. But overall, I'm genuinely impressed with this new IDE. And I think I'll be using this more in the future as it's free of cost as of now. And we can try it out and provide feedback to the AWS teams as well. What do you think about this overall? I would like your thoughts as well on this. If you're excited about this, just leave a comment. If you want to learn more about such tools, which I'll be demoing in the future, subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching.